In 2016, astronomers announced the discovery of GNZ11, a galaxy with the farthest distance ever seen. And this picture depicts how this galaxy appeared 400 million years following the Big Bang. And fast forward to today, where is this galaxy now? Well, looking at one paper, the galaxy is currently located at a whopping distance of 32 billion light years away from us. Wait a second. To our best understanding, we know that the universe is 13.75 billion years old. So how could there be a galaxy exceeding far beyond the 13.75 billion light year distance? How is this possible? Would it mean that we could see beyond the speed of light? Well, in this video, we will explore the mystery of our ever-expanding universe and beyond. The expansion of the early universe is adequately explained by the Big Bang theory. That explosion started it all, from a single point of singularity until everything that now exists. Because of this Big Bang, it is thought that the expansion of the universe will eventually slow down, owing to the attracting aspect of gravity, namely the gravitational attractions from the stars and galaxies. So until recently, all evidence supported this accelerated expansion without any exceptions. Observations such as the CMBR and the redshift of galaxies supported this theory. However, in 1998, two research groups from the Berkeley Lab and the Supernova Cosmology Project found something strange. As expansion can't be observed directly, they looked for other effects caused by expansion and deduced the expansion speed based on these observations. By using reliable data from all over the skies, both teams independently discovered that distant supernova seemed to be dimmer than expected. Keep in mind that the farther away an object is, the longer it takes its light to reach us. So that means that supernova are further away than expected and have traveled a longer distance before reaching us. The researchers claim that when they look at these objects, they look further into the past, to about 7 to 9 billion years ago. This finding shattered the previous theories of slowed down expansion, which would mean that the universe expansion is accelerating instead of slowing down. And just recently, in May 2018, a research team from the Dark Energy Survey has released the largest map so far, which looks something like this. From galaxies to supernova observations. Their finding continued to support this expansion rate change, with a pretty surprising twist. These changes are accelerating over time. Yes, it was all happening regardless of the effect of gravity we talked about before. To put it another way, we can call it the accelerating expansion, a phenomenon that has never been observed in physics before, according to what we know. All of this rumination and theorizing then boils down to bigger questions. What is the cause of this expansion? And more importantly, why is the universe expanding? Let's dig deeper into this topic in the next chapter. To answer why the universe expands, it's critical to first understand what caused the expansion. The scientific consensus so far is due to the mysterious dark energy that permeates nearly all of space. Of course, the term dark doesn't really imply that it's dark at all. It's just called dark energy because nobody knows what it is or where it comes from. We can't even see it directly, since light can't travel through such a dense and pervasive field, unlike normal matter. It just doesn't behave as anything physicists know about. Also, the name implies this as energy, like gravity or radiation. But in reality, there isn't any physical evidence for this. When you really dig deep into the theories, there's no way how dark energy can interact with matter or radiation. It just operates in a completely different manner. That's why some researchers are calling it phantom energy. At the moment of the Big Bang, this dark energy was created as soon as expansion began, and thusly pushed everything further apart from each other, as time has passed on by since then. The expansion of dark energy is constant, but mainly not uniform in nature. There are regions where expansion happens much faster than others. Take, for example, a constellation named Hydra. In the relatively far future, due to a faster rate of expansion there, all galaxies in the Hydra constellation will be outside our cosmic horizon. It's not that all of it will be gone immediately, but it's going to be pushed away from our view, beyond our visible universe. All information they contain about their existence will be lost forever. Imagine if this were to happen today on nearby objects from us, say the planets in our solar system. If they begin to move away from us faster than the universe's current rate of expansion, eventually all information about the solar system would disappear beyond the horizon. our future grandchildren wouldn't know that there was something called Jupiter and Saturn. This may be the most disheartening thing you hear today. When expansion seems to be much higher than expected for a given gravity and density of the object, we call this effect gravity enhancement. The phenomenon was first discovered by Nobel laureate Saul Perlmutter, astrophysicist Adam Ries, and the Supernova Cosmology Project. They found out that expansion was much faster than it should be if dark energy expansion is constant everywhere. These observations helped us understand the phenomenon of the universe expansion, as well as the nature of dark energy. But this finding still doesn't answer why expansion occurs in the first place. One popular speculation is that expansion happens due to a mechanism called vacuum metastability. It is an idea that expansion might be due to a universe being in a quantum fluctuation from nothing. Or in other words, an expansion might simply be a result of our universe spontaneously popping out from nothingness. Perhaps expansion is an inherent result of expansion itself. The rate grows exponentially due to a feedback loop that feeds on dark energy tension. At this point, it's only logical if we ask the question, where does it lead us then? What is the consequence of an accelerating expansion? Can any living being even survive it? Some pretty fascinating questions, so let's go through them in detail in the next part of this video. The concept of this accelerating expansion ultimately leads to a new framework on how we view the cosmos. And this idea is nothing less than the expansion of our universe without end. You heard it right, without an end. Imagine the expansion of the universe continues to infinity, with smaller and smaller galaxies moving apart from each other. Maybe the expansion will become weaker at some point, but in this case, it will never stop. So what happens then when the expansion wouldn't pull everything back together? To be clear, we have no idea yet, because our physical theories are not able to explain this phenomenon so far. But there are some possible outcomes, of course, with each being more malignant than the previous one. So let's go through these cases in detail. Case 1. The expansion halts at a point. It's possible that expansion will stop at a certain point, because it becomes weaker over time as gravity becomes stronger. Remember in the earlier part of the video, where we discussed that gravity attracts and, of course, expansion repels. It's like yin and yang, a cycle that is eternally opposed to one another. In one way, as gravity grows stronger, this could lead to everything falling back together into a massive black hole, from which no light could escape for eternity. And maybe even before that, what remains of our universe might collapse under its own weight, due to all matter being crushed together so densely. Case 2. Expansion is slowed down until gravity overcomes expansion's power. In this second case, the expansion would become weaker and weaker until it is slowed down by gravity. At this point, expansion would take over again, pulling back everything together only to be halted by gravity again. The cycle could continue forever until expansion becomes so slow that it cannot overcome the strong pull of gravity. Both are constantly changing each other's power as cycles repeat themselves endlessly. In this case, there will never be an end to the universe, as both expansion and gravity create new universes from nothing, as the old one becomes weaker. And this brings us back to the beginning of expansion without end, or expansion for expansion's sake. Case 3. Expand forever faster until all matters are ripped apart into nothingness. In this scenario, expansion is so powerful that it would simply overcome the pull of gravity, no matter how hard gravity tries. Eventually, this would lead to the Big Rip, a hypothetical scenario in the future when the expansion will be so great that everything from atoms themselves will be ripped apart into oblivion. Nothing would stop expansion from taking over again and again. All matter and even space itself wouldn't survive beyond that point. Everything moving away from each other at an ever-increasing speed, until everything is ripped out of existence. This is truly the darkest timeline for us all. The physical evidence just tells us expansion is happening and will continue exponentially if left alone to its own devices. This means that perhaps dark energy will create a scenario where our universe will essentially rip itself apart after trillions upon trillions of years into the future. Yet there are so many possibilities left unknown. The latest data points to accelerated expansion, which only throws the future of our civilization into more uncertainty. And all we know is that expansion has no end so far. But what if it does at some point? Just like our universe today, this cycle could repeat itself endlessly within itself, with expansion creating more expansion over time. Expansion that has no end, present nor foreseeable future on human timescales. All we can do is hope for the best result, while preparing for the worst, which hopefully won't occur anytime soon. If this video has been helpful in any way, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Also press the bell notification button for more curiosity videos like this. And I know that you've been waiting for part 2 of the series, the absolute mind-bending topic about our universe. I can safely say that it's coming up next right after this. I'll see you then in that video. Thanks.